Ready for today's topic? So guys, our today's topic is peripheral nervous system. And we are on the channel Satyam Idol Learning. Okay, and we have a goal for cracking it, for having it. NEET exam, when not exam, NEET exam. All the exams are combined, AIIMS, JIMMAR, okay, and NEET only. Okay, so we have to crack it and have it, okay. So guys, our today's topic is what? Peripheral nervous system. Guys, if you have not subscribed our channel yet, so subscribe it and hit the bell icon so that all the notifications of the updated video can go through you. Okay, now let's discuss about our topic, peripheral nervous system. As what we have already discussed, central nervous system. We have already discussed about central nervous system. Those who have not watched my previous video, then watch it and have it. And then we will be discussing about peripheral nervous system. Guys, share it as much as you can, because vidya baatne se badhti hai. And what are its goal? We are only हम शेयर ही जितना करेंगे तभी तो सब में बढ़ेगी तभी तो हमारा इंडिया बढ़ेगा और बढ़ेगा. सो गाइस, लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट पेरिफेरल नर्वस सिस्टम. नाउ इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ नर्व्स दैट कनेक्ट द सीएनएस विद ऑल पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी. ओके, सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज सीएनएस. सीएनएस इज सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम. इट इज अ शॉर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ सीएनएस, सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम. ओके, so it consists of what? Peripheral nervous system consists of nerves, okay, which connect to the CNS and all the parts of the body. Okay, so it consists of nerves which connect the all parts of the body and the CNS. And see, it comprises of 43 pairs of nerves. We say, see, there are many numerous nerves which are divided and sub branches are there. There are many numerous of nerves are there present in our body. Okay, but we say that mainly there are 43 pairs of nerves. It comprises of peripheral nervous system, comprises of 43 pairs of nerves. Okay, peripheral nervous system. And in this 43 pair of nerves, no, now 43 has been came from 12 pair of cranial nerves and 31 pair of spinal nerves. Excuse me. See, 43 pair of nerves come from 12 pair of cranial nerves and 31 pair of spinal nerves. Okay, see, cranial nerves are, that is why called, because the 12 pair of nerves are coming from the brain. Okay, from the brain they are coming, that is why they are known as cranial nerves. So there are 12 pair of cranial nerves and 31 pair of spinal nerves. Spinal nerves are, that is why called, because they are coming from the spinal cord. We have no spinal cord, and from the spinal cord only there are 31 pair of spinal nerves. Clear? And then when we will add it, 31 plus 12, it will form 43 pair of nerves. So peripheral nervous system consists of, comprises of 43 pair of nerves, and see, 31 spinal nerves and 12 cranial nerves. This you have to remember, guys. Okay, see, and each pair of nerves consists of two nerves. Okay, each pair of nerve consists of two nerves, and in which two nerves, one is of sensory nerve and one is of motor nerve. Okay, one is of motor nerve and one is of sensory nerve. Sensory nerve carries impulses from the sense organs to the brain or the spinal cord, and the motor nerve carry impulses from the brain or the spinal cord to the effector organs. Okay, so that is how it is working, and we have already discussed about in central nervous system in greater detail. And there is one more topic which I have given about neuron. This is one full video of neuron. I don't know, 10 to 20 minutes it is off, and full structure and function it has been discussed about the neuron. Okay, so you can go and watch it. I will give the link in the description box. Okay, so don't feel worried. No, so PNS carries impulses to and from sensory organs and convey messages to effector organs. Okay, so it carries impulses to and from the sensory organs. Now, what is sensory organ? Sensory organ, as you already know, our tongue, skin is a sensory organ, nose is a sensory organ, and eye is sensory organ. We have been discussed, and the brain is sensory organ. So PNS carries, PNS means peripheral nervous system, there has been written. PNS carries impulses to and from the sensory organs. To and from the sensory organs means that, for example, I am taking that to and from the skin. Okay, so there is a nerve which is carrying impulse from the skin to and from the skin. Okay, I am just giving an example. And conveying messages to whom? It will convey messages to effector organs. Okay, effector organs is an organ which has been acted. Okay, it is acting. So effector organs is an organ which is acting in response to the impulses. Okay, so it acts in response to the impulses. Clear? This thing, I think it will be crystal clear. Okay, now PNS, peripheral nervous system, I am repeating so that you can be clear. Okay, crystal clear ho jana chahiye sabko, bata raha hu. Okay, see, PNS has two component. PNS has two component. Hamari video dekhkar to hota hi hai crystal clear sabko. See, peripheral nervous system has two component, somatic and autonomic nervous system. Okay, so what are the two components? Somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. Somatic nervous system, or we can say somatic nervous system, another name is voluntary nervous system. Okay, and autonomic nervous systems, another name is involuntary nervous system. So you know the other names of the somatic nervous system and the autonomic nervous system. I'm repeating, just write it down. If you have not, I have not given the notes. See guys, all the notes are available. You can take the screenshot. Okay, so somatic nervous system, for somatic nervous system or voluntary nervous system, and autonomic nervous system or involuntary nervous system. Okay, now the SNS, I have written the short form, somatic nervous system or voluntary nervous system. So the SNS, S for somatic, N for nervous, and S for system. So somatic nervous system carries information from the sense organs. Okay, it carries information from the sense organs and regulates movement of the skeletal muscles accordingly. Okay, so SNS is mainly involved in voluntary activities. Okay, voluntary activities are those activities which are in control of us. See, I am moving my hand, no? It is a voluntary activity. It is a kind of voluntary activity. And that is how it has been written, that the SNS carries information from the sense organs. So sense organ, I am taking an example like skin. Skin is a sense organ. Now, there is a nerve from the skin and it is going to the skeletal muscle. In our hand, there are skeletal muscles like biceps and triceps. I am giving an example. So the nerve will go to the biceps or triceps or the skeletal muscles, we say simply. So they will go to the skeletal muscles, and then the skeletal muscles will regulate the movement accordingly only. Okay, so the impulses will go to the skeletal muscles, and then the skeletal muscles will regulate the movements accordingly only. Okay, now come on, ANS. ANS stands for autonomic nervous system. A for autonomic, N for nervous, and S for system, or involuntary system, involuntary nervous system. Sorry, involuntary nervous system or autonomic nervous system. See, ANS is controlled by medulla oblongata. As we have already discussed in our previous video, that medulla oblongata controls the involuntary actions. Okay, we have discussed that medulla oblongata controls involuntary actions, and cerebellum controls both voluntary as well as involuntary actions, and cerebrum controls voluntary actions. We have already discussed. You can see the video. So ANS, or the autonomic nervous system, is controlled by medulla oblongata and is concerned with execution of involuntary activities. Okay, so there has been written that it is concerned with the execution of involuntary activities. So as you know by the involuntary activities, it is not in our will. In voluntary, as I have told you, that voluntary means in our will. It is in our will. And then it is, in has been written. So it will be involuntary, means it is not in our will. Okay. So, and it is concerned with execution of involuntary activities like swallowing. When you swallow, it is not in your will. Okay. And the movement of the alimentary canal. Okay. This is not in our will. Okay. And the moving of the kidneys, lungs, lungs is in our will. Heartbeat, sorry. I am giving an example. Heartbeat. Okay. So, heartbeat is an example. And swallowing, I have given. Alimentary canal movement is an example. Okay. Peristalsis movement is there. I have been discussed about in the digestive system this. Okay. Now, come on that. ANS is divided into sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. Okay. So, the ANS, autonomic nervous system, is further divided into sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. Parasympathetic nervous system and sympathetic nervous system. Now, what are these? When we say in simple language that the sympathetic nervous system, former, see, first we read out and then I will explain you. See, former raises the level of an organ's activity, while the latter decreases the organ's activity. See guys, former and latter is not any term. It is not at all a term. Okay. It is just an English language. When we speak, no, former is for, see, most of the students will be knowing, but there are some of the students which are not knowing that former means pehla, okay, first, and the latter means baad ka, okay. So former means first and the latter means baad ka. So former is used for this sympathetic nervous system and the latter is used for the parasympathetic nervous system. Okay. Remember this thing. Don't be confused in this thing. Okay. So I am explaining that former, in the simple language, when we say that the former raises the sympathetic nervous system, raises the level of an organ's activity, while the parasympathetic nervous system decreases the organ's activity. Okay. The organ's activity is in decreased mode in the parasympathetic nervous system, while it is in increased mode in the sympathetic nervous system. Okay. Now, what are the examples so that we can learn it? See, for example, you are running, you are doing physical exercise. When you do physical exercise, you need more and more oxygen, because you are releasing energy. Okay. You are doing work. So energy is produced. Okay. So that is why for consuming that energy, we need oxygen. Okay. So for needing oxygen, the heartbeat will be fast from the normal rate. It will be increased. So that there will be increase of an heartbeat, for the rate of the heartbeat. So when we will be doing physical exercises, then the rate of the heartbeat increases for need of oxygen, and it comes in the sympathetic nervous system. Okay. It is means, see, the level of an organ activity is increasing, no? So the heartbeat is pumping more and more blood, no? That is why it is coming in the sympathetic nervous system. Now, in parasympathetic nervous system, see, the latter decreases the organ's activity. Now, when you will be at the rest mode, I have done the physical exercise, now I am in the rest mode. Now, the heartbeat will come to the normal position. There are nerves coming from the parasympathetic nervous system also and the sympathetic nervous system. And this nerve only gives them what to do. Okay? So, the nerve will increase the organ's activity in the sympathetic nervous system case. Now, in the case of parasympathetic nervous system, when we will add the rest mode. Now, the rate of the blood pressure, the rate of the heartbeat, sorry, not the blood pressure, the rate of the heartbeat is decreased and come to a normal position. Normal pressure, it will came to a normal rate. Okay, so the heartbeat will be at the normal rate when you have done physical exercise and you are at the rest mode. Okay, so as we have already discussed, that it is increasing organ's activity and it is decreasing the organ activity. So our peripheral nervous system is completed, guys. If you have any doubts, then please comment it on the comment section box. There has been written comment. Okay, so you can comment it and subscribe our channel if you have not done and like it. Okay, and share it also. Don't forget to share, because knowledge baantne se badhti hai.